What's up, guys? Luckless NInja here, bringing you a beginner's guide to Zed. Zed's awesome. No explanation needed. Anyway, gonna start out the game here, as we do every game, picking up our first ability. In this case, it's gonna be our Q, raise a shuriken. It's that. Throws a shuriken, does exactly what it sounds like it does, and pick up our first items. We're gonna start out with a long sword, some health pots, and a warding totem. So, long sword gives you a lot of early damage, which is really good. And the health pots, they help sustain through lane. Because Zed, levels 1 through 3, not the best. However, once you hit 5, 4, and really once you hit 6, then you start coming into your own. So, let's take a look at his abilities here while we have free time waiting for minions. Your passive is Contempt for the Weak. Whenever you hit something below 50% health, you deal an additional percent of their max health as magic damage. That's huge. That means that if you punch someone below half health, they're taking a huge, huge amount of damage. So, also makes last hitting very easy. So, your Q, Razor Shuriken, throws a shuriken, does damage, does less damage for each thing it hits. Fairly simple. Your W is what makes Zed so much fun. He throws out a shadow that copies all of his abilities. So, if I were to throw out a shadow here, then I can use it to throw shurikens, I can use it with my E. It's cool. Also, you can jump to any shadows you have out. Gives you a lot of playmaking potential, a lot of jukes. It's a lot of fun. Also, gives you a passive attack damage buff, which is cool. Your E is an AoE slash. If your shadow slash hits someone, so that's the slash done by the shadow version of you, then it also slows. So, what you can do, and I'll show you guys later, is you can set up with a shadow, and then hit him with the shadow slash, and then after that, immediately land a Q on him for some very, very easy damage. Alright, just gonna throw out some Qs here, try to poke a bit, try to get as many minions as we can, not be terrible. Bopper with a Q there, doing a good chunk of damage. So, just gonna try to zone her. Alright. Gonna pick up our E now.
The shadows have enlightened me.
And yeah. So this is fairly easy. Normally you wanna pick up your shadow second, but I really just kinda wanna try to push this up under her turret. So. Yeah, as you guys can see, out damaging her a fair amount. Just continuing to push. The Fiora's here. Alright, now gonna pick up our shadow. So, we saw the Fiora. Throw a shuriken with our shadow. Get that CS. We're doing pretty good. So, Cat's pushed up under a turret. Gonna be a fairly easy kill here in a minute. Fiora's here. She's not gonna do anything, really. But she's here. Alright, if she walks up, I'm gonna bop her with my shadow. Get some slashes off, get some shurikens.
Balance is a fool's master.
And really, because she's so low now, she can't come up to get these minions. We're gonna try to keep it that way. Oh, didn't have enough energy for my shurikens. That would have been a kill. She's still staying. Interesting choice. Alright, first blood going down in the bot lane. Alright, when our shadow's up, she gets just a bit closer. We're gonna go absolutely ham. Leveling up our Q first here for the damage it gives us. Just zoning shadow. Alright, barrier coming out. Don't normally see barrier on Cat, but hey. Alright, we are now out of health pots. She still has two more, so. Let's see. Don't want to take too much poke. There you go. As you guys can see, nailing her with the shuriken there. Just being spooky. Yep, I knew that was coming. Saw the dagger coming, and. Yeah, that was really dumb. Should have gone back a little bit earlier. But I wanted to stick around, try to get my brutalizer. Oh well. Anyway, gonna pick up another longsword here. Pick up some more health pots. Grab some boots. And then head back to lane. Just gonna use our shadow here for a bit more move speed. Azed's an energy champion. He doesn't have mana, so you can really just spam your stuff all you want. So, no reason not to. Alright, now she just went back, so we want to push this as hard as we can, try to get as many minions under a turret, and we have double her CS. So while she may have gotten a kill off on us, I have done. We're still pretty even. Just get as many of these minions as we can, use our abilities, there we go.
No technique is forbidden. Alright.
So, just sitting here, farming up. So first thing we want to try to get is that brutalizer, because that's going to give us some cooldown reduction, some more armor pen. It's going to let us do a lot of damage. Stop that. Alright, so Cat is 6. Need to be really careful here, because when Cat hits 6, she gets her ult, which does absurd amounts of damages. The shadows have enlightened. The amount of damage that actually does is really pretty stupid. Using our Shadow Slash there, get some CS. Get that one. Throw a Shuriken. Alright. Also, very easy to CS under turret, because you know, we're Zed. So, we can just kind of hit them after the turret hits them, and it's very, very easy. So we don't have to worry about being pushed under turret here. The shadow is within. But I don't want to be giving more kills to Cat, because Cat snowballs incredibly hard. Incredibly hard. So, if we can just make her try to CS, and try to deny her as much CS as possible without giving her a kill, we're going to wind up ahead.
Secrets kept are weapons wasted.
Alright, not getting hit by that bouncing blade. Use shurikens to get some minions. She's gonna try to jump us here. Yep. Yeah.
Without a sound.
Not gonna lie, this one's not too much fun. Alright, bopping with a good chunk of damage there. Keep leveling up our Q. Just for extra poke damage, lets us CS from a distance. You know, four times like this when we really don't want to get close.
Balance is a fool's master.
Getting both of those. Alright. Got a good chunk of money here now. Also, out of HP pots. Don't really want to go back because she's going to push us under our turret and make us miss a whole lot. If Udyr can come and gank us real quick, well, gank for us. Alright, getting all of those. Getting some damage off on the Cat. Really, like I said, just farming up. So, we're trying to get that early brutalizer. Missed the minion. We're trying to get an early brutalizer. Gonna follow it up with a Bork. Bork's great. Gives you a slow. Gives you some HP damage. Gives you a move speed buff. She's gonna try to jump us here. Yeah. She's gonna take a lot of damage from that. Honestly, we can kill her now. So, she stays. We're gonna W, ult, ignite, and try to burst her. Yeah. This could go great, this could go terribly. She still has barrier, so I want the Udyr to show up.
Brave the shadows.
Alright, come on. Oh. Meant to jump to that shadow there. Didn't quite happen. So, my bad. I'll completely admit that was me screwing up. But It does get Kat out of our way for a while. It blows her barrier. Gives us a chance to heal up a bit.
None escape their
shadow. And now we're back to denying the Kat farm. So. Here comes the Rammus. Just gonna be a drive-by. Not gonna do much. So we actually have a lot of money here. Kinda wanna go back. When I say kinda, I really wanna go back. Because we have a lot of money. We have a lot of money, we have our ult. We can make some rooms here in a minute. Don't get hit by the bouncing blade.
Position is the corpse of wisdom.
Alright. So. 70 CS, 11 minutes. Not great. Not terrible by any means, but not great.
Only the worthy will survive.
Alright. I think I'm just gonna go back here. Got 1600 gold. That's a lot. Just watching her to see what's happening. Alright. She does not try to jump us. That's good. Gonna pick up this. Gonna grab some Moby boots. Moby boots are great. They let Zed roam. Let him do some damages elsewhere on the map. Gonna pick up another longsword and some wards. So as I said, first things first, grabbing a brutalizer. Gives us a lot of early damage, cooldown reduction. Kat is missing. Yeah, definitely should have told them that earlier. Looks like Rammus is dead. They're gonna kill the Kat though. And now because Kat is dead, push this out really hard. Take advantage of this. They went really deep down there. Alright. So, there's that. How's this looking? Wukong's decently low. Cat's dead, so don't gotta worry about Ursa. So, like I said, trying to push this as hard as possible. Want Cat to miss as much as possible. And, if I can take this turret, I'm not going to. But I'm definitely going to put some pressure on it. Or am I going to take it? Bard. You're dead.
Secrets kept our weapons.
Yeah, so that was easy kill. Bard is trying to come stop us from taking the turret. I guess he did that pretty well. But we got a kill. Not really worth. So, I want to stick around just a bit longer. Because I want to get the cutlass on my back. That's going to give us a slow. It's going to give us lifesteal. It's good stuff. Alright. She's dead. So, I died. She died as well, though. I'm not really sure if that was worth or not. But, she did use a summoner where I did not. So, I'm gonna say that gives us the advantage. I'm gonna say that gives us the advantage. Probably doesn't, but we got a ton of damage off on their turret. Ours is still plenty healthy. I can come back to lane, take that very easily, and then I can just run around the map doing whatever I want. Gank going off top lane, killing the Wukong. This is looking pretty good for us, guys. It's looking pretty good. Especially as their team is incredibly snowball heavy. I mean, they have a Fiora, a Cat, a Wukong. Well, even more, a damage Wukong. So, the fact that they're not doing well is really good for us. Alright, using my shadow. Get back a bit faster. Hit that one, hit that one. Shadow slash. Miss minions like a professional. Alright, let's see. We're both level 10. Cat has a needless. She's going for an early death cap. Nailing her with both of those for some big damages. Alright, so she does not have her barrier, which means I could probably 100 to 0 her when the next wave comes. Alright, Fiora's here. Alright, let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Bear slap. No bear slap. Alright, so if he got that stun off there, Cat was definitely gonna die. So, throw some shurikens, keep pushing, because I want to put pressure on this turret. We have a lot of people here. Come on, jump me. Jump me, I dare you. I've got an Udyr. I've got, I always forget what that guy's called because I never see him. Oh, Urgot. Got Udyr, we got Urgot. They're all right there. If I can keep Cat here for the dragon fight. Oh, chunking. Okay. Flashing out. Dodging Hurl, killing her. So, I was pretty dead there when Fiora came in. I knew there was no way I was getting out of that alive. But, means I kept their jungler distracted and got a kill while our team got the dragon. I'm gonna say that's worth. So, picking up the recurve bow, once again, building toward the Bork. This is also gonna help us out with split pushing a lot, because Zed is an amazing split pusher. As you guys can see, Zed does tons and tons of damage. He's very good at killing people. But, as you guys saw from beating on the turret here, he's also very good at taking turrets. Now, normally as Zed, you want to be trying to roam around the map, making plays before you get your turret down. But, I haven't really seen too many chances for that. Gangplank is kind of destroying top. You know, bot is... I'm not really sure what's going on, bot. I'm completely honest, I have no clue what's going on there. So, I'm gonna try to destroy this turret before Cat gets back. I think we can do it. Okay. It's not quite down yet. But it's getting there. Alright, let's see. So, dodging the bouncing blade. Nailing her with some shurikens. I think those hit. I'm gonna say they did. She now has a full death cap, so really don't want to get caught by her ult. There's an Udyr here. She is very dead. So, Udyr comes in, bops her for the stun, hit her with a slow for my shadow, and there was nothing she could do. Absolutely nothing. Gonna tell the Udyr good job, because easy kills equals free money. This is gonna get us a turret as well. Things are looking good, guys. Things are looking good. Good. So, now that we've got a turret, we're coming by. Let's see. They might be able to kill everyone before we show up. Yeah, they're all pretty dead. Let's go for this turret, though. So, if Graves sticks around, I can kill him. No doubt, 100%, he's gonna die. Because we have our Cutlass slow, we have our ult. Ooh, Wukong's here? Wukong is here. I'm gonna step on that, gonna squish that one. Alright, just gonna ult out. Alright, there we go. Graves died. Missed the slow, but he's still dead. Alright, see if Cat comes up. Whoa! Didn't think Udyr was still around. Forgot about him. So this is gonna be... That's a turret. Cool. Alright. Fiora's here. Yeah, we need to go. Or we're just gonna kill her. I'm cool. That's good by me. So, what was that? 3 for 2? Because we killed the Graves. We killed the Wukong. We killed the Cat. We killed the Fiora. Bard died. No, we killed them all. We got a turret. This is going to be our Bork. Up next, Last Whisper. Making sure that there is zero armor on the enemy team by the time we're done. Because Last Whisper gives you tons of damages simply by absolutely destroying the enemy armor. Also gives a good chunk of AD as well. So, good things are good. Still have wards sitting in my inventory because I haven't really had time to put them out. Probably shouldn't do that. Wards don't really help you if you're sitting there in your pocket. Pro tip of the day. Alright, Gangplank gonna hold to clear out the minions here. So yeah.
Oh.
just gonna jump back to my ult. We're probably pretty dead here. Yeah. So Wukong showed up, he ulted, we're dead. Got a kill off on the Graves though, and the more we can beat down the enemy AD carry, the better off we're gonna be. Looks like Wukong might be in some trouble here. Nah, cat's there, they're gonna be fine. So 200 gold away from my last Whisper. And this is looking pretty good for us, guys. This is looking pretty good. Alright. Yeah, Wukong, still going full damage, monkey. Graves, full damage as well, cat. Basically, I can kill all of them. And that is a wonderful feeling for an assassin, is being able to burst down anyone and everyone on the enemy team. Because that means that they cannot answer us when we start split pushing. Which, by the way, three of them mid. Udyr can push bot, Gangplank can push top. Telling the... I always forget his name. Urgot that Wukong's coming bot. Yep, giving him just enough time to get out of there. Cool. And now, we can go for a mid turret. So, using our abilities to push here. Dragon's up in 20 seconds. Alright, there's a Fiora here. I don't want none of this. Sorry, friend, you're pretty dead. Throw that out. Keep running. They're gonna get the Graves, though. I should be able to keep them from getting this turret, because none of them have any armor, like, at all. None. They just don't. They're all going full damage. And that is incredibly risky. There we go. She dies, I can ult out. Gonna die to the Fiora. Oh well. Can pick up our last Whisper here. Now, what is Brutalizer still built into? Forgot they changed the Black Cleaver. Alright. So yeah, gonna turn the Brutalizer here into a Yomu's now. We have our last Whisper, we're doing tons of damages. We're 6-5, not doing bad. Also have 4 assists. Doing pretty good. That's involvement in almost half the kills. Yeah. That's pretty good. Alright, are we gonna see some plays getting made? We are not. I think they probably should have gone in a bit sooner. I'm gonna go clear out mid, and then I think it's time to split push top. Unless we're gonna team fight here. No, those two are just gonna die. They went a bit too deep, going too far into the enemy team. Alright, get all these minions. Graves is here. We have ult in 10. Weakness. I can kill him so easy. So easy. I want to go so bad. Udyr wants to go too. Let's go. Alright, he's gonna die here too. Shadow out. Alright. Was hoping that would hit him. It does not. Gangplank ult coming in big. Whoop, don't want to be tanking this turret here. Hit the minions. Yeah, flashing over the wall. Nope, 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 nope. I want none of this. Alright, we're gonna be fine. We're significantly less fine now. Yeah, so, Bard ult. Actually doing something useful. You don't see that too often. This Bard's actually decently good. Not something I say every day. Alright. So, still, 7-6-5. Helped get some more kills there. Urgot, still pushing bot. Still split pushing. Has his man immune. He's pretty dead here. Yeah. I think it's time to group. Oh, no. I just got my young boost. Couldn't have used that. So, it's definitely time to group, because as a team, we are way stronger than these guys. You know, we have tanks where they are full damage. Like, every single one of them is absolutely full damage. Except Bard. Bard's... I don't know what Bard's doing. Almost looks like he's going for one of those little Void Baby spawners. The ZZ Rot portal. But that's a really, really strange item to pick up on a support.
Break the shadows, find the truth.
Alright, so let's see. How many of them do we have here? Pinging things. It's getting pinged. Okay, so there's Bard. There's that. Wukong using a stop there. Looked like he was going to use his shadow to go in. Alright, we're all here. Let's go. Alright. Rammus. Rammus is doing Rammus things. I don't know what Rammus is doing. So, he shows up. He can get a big taunt, get off a big ult. He can do some big things here. Just going to do that. Some poke. Actually get off a lot of poke on him. Hitting three or four people with those shurikens. Alright, I really don't want to go 5v4 here. So, I'm going to back off just a little bit. Chunking Wukong. Boom. This is problem. Alright, getting some kills there. Helping get some other kills. That's three dead. That's four dead. Come on. Are we going to get them all? Yes. That's an ace. Alright. Good job, guys. So, we got Bard ulted there. That started the fight. So then they jumped in. I was caught in the middle of the enemy team. So, immediately decided to jump on top of whoever I could and burst. So, jumping on top of the cat. Just insta-bursting her. Or as near to as I could. Gives us a definite advantage in the fight. After that, Rammus shows up, some big taunts happen. We're gonna get an inhib. This is really good for us. Cat shows up, that's gonna be a problem, but they got this. So, up next, gonna get a Maw. Well, actually, let's see. What should we get? So, take a look at what their team does. Wukong, Fiora, Graves, all heavy AD. We might honestly just want some tankiness. So in most games, you want to try to get more damage and burst the carries. But here, we're not having an issue with that. So I'm thinking I'm just going to get an Omen. So this is a rather not standard pickup on Zed. But because they have so much damage, and I need to be able to survive to kill someone,
no technique is forbidden.
You know, need to be able to survive the insta burst that their guys have to be able to kill all of them, and we're already doing so much damage simply because we're Zed and we have the Last Whisper, we have all that. Gangplank wants his minions. Alright, I was going to start split pushing top, start doing Zed things, I can talk today. But, looks like that's not going to be the case. Bard is here. Graves, you are so dead. Yeah, Graves is in the wrong part of town. I really don't know what he was doing there, that was really questionable. So, just walking up behind him, killing them all.
Brave the shadows, find the truth.
Let's see, did we get the Bard too? Nah, just the Graves. Or maybe. Whoop, we need to get out. Flashing out. We're probably dead here. Yeah, we're dead. Still, you guys can see how much damage we do, right? That's absurd. That's absolutely ridiculous. So, we don't need any more damage. We don't need it. We just really don't at this point, because no one has armor. No one. I mean, the Bard a little bit. Fiora's not going to get damage. Cat's not going to get damage. Wukong's going full damage, Wukong. I mean, there's no reason to get more attack damage. Yeah, I guess we could try to burst them faster, but they're already dying, you know? Alright. So, let's grab some armor.
No,
and head on back out. Alright, can we Baron? I think we probably can, because they can't stand up to us in a team fight. Graves is gonna die here. Yeah, Graves is pretty dead here. We should Baron. Because it'll be a 5v4 fight if they come to try to stop us. If they don't try to stop us, it's a free Baron. Alright, Rammus gonna be saving the Urgot here. Yora's gonna die. Alright, he's dead. So yeah. This is free if we want to take it. I don't know if we can though, because there's only three of us now. I think instead we just push for top turret. Because when you get a big kill like that, you have to go take something else. Because at the end of the day, the game is about taking out the Nexus. Nobody cares if you killed a million of them if they get the Nexus and you don't. So if you just kill everyone and then go back and sit in your base, I mean, yeah, I guess you can buy items and stuff. But, you know, that's not going to help you if you... Alright, he's going deep. Alright, let's see. Yeah, he died really fast. Does he have any defenses yet? Nope. Just cornmail. Not so. Triforce and Bork. That's what I meant to say. This is kind of sketchy at the moment, because they're all here, I'm low, and there's only three of us at the moment. So it looks like Fiora's coming. Cat's here too. I don't want this. I want none of this. Alright. He's right there. We have ult in 10. There's three of them. Rammus is here.
Do not fear the shrouded path.
Alright, let's kill Graves. It's warded. Yeah. But we should be able to kill this Graves. If I'm right, he's gonna go back here. Oh, hello, Graves. You're very dead. So, easy kills. We saw him out there, and anytime an AD carry is out on their own, that's free food. If you're playing Zed and there's an AD carry on your own and you don't go insta-kill them, you're just not doing your job. Alright, Hero's gonna walk up here, hit her with a Shadow Slash. We're gonna be fine. Yeah, we got our Moby Boots. She's not gonna catch us. Fiora, looks like you might be in trouble here, friend. I'm gonna let them find her first, because I don't want to deal with Fiora insta-killing me. So, she's dead here. Yep, Baron's right here. We got four dudes. Let's do this. I'm not gonna tank this one. Using our Yomus for a little bit more damage here. Wanna try to burst this down as quick as possible. Bard ulting himself. Okay. Alright, he's gonna die. Shadow. Not the Shadow, our ult taking him out. I'm just now realizing I haven't actually explained our ult, so let's do that. So, what your ult does, and you guys have seen it multiple times this game, is you jump to an enemy, you drop a Shadow from where you started, and then you land on top of them, and you give them a mark. And what this mark does is it stores up part of the damage that you deal to them. Not stores up, but part of the damage that they take over that time is stored up into the mark. And then when the mark detonates, they take all that. So, that's what the little spinning shuriken over their head is. That tells you that they're gonna die. And then, you having the Shadow from where you jumped in, you just press R and you get out.
Brave the shadows.
Very, very easy kills. Very, very good. Now we have a Randuin's. Gives us a slow as well. Makes us a lot tankier against their team. And you guys see, we killed them all. I mean, there's not a single one of them who can stand and fight us. They just can't. So we don't need more damage. Ordinarily, yeah, I'd be getting more damage. I'd be getting things like a Bloodthirster, something that just gives a lot of AD. But I don't need that at the moment. Because you guys have seen just how much damage we do. You know? And if I can kill all of them, but they can't kill me, that is a very, very good place for us. So that's one of the problems of going full AD, or full damage, is that if you fall behind and you can't kill them all before they can kill you, then you're gonna die. Kill this guy too. There we go. As you guys can see, we just do massive amounts of damage. We didn't use our Yomus, we didn't use our Bork. We still have all of that stuff. You know? If that doesn't show you just the absolutely absurd amount of damage that Zed does, I don't know what will. Who you're gonna die to the Bard, apparently. Just gonna get that. Get out. Shadow Slash the Bard. Can you stop that? We're gonna be fine. Getting really fast. What the heck? Alright. So, that was interesting. I wanted to get the inhib there. Really did. So, up next, I think I might just go for the Black Cleaver. It's going to give us some cooldown reduction, it's going to give us some move speed when we hit people, and more damage, and more Armor Shred. Because one of the things about Armor Shred is that it goes really good with more Armor Shred. So, the more their armor that you take away, the better off you are. So, yeah, Wukong still full damage. Katarina finally picking up some magic resist against really no one on our team. That's interesting, I guess. I mean, Rammus? I don't know. I really don't know. That's interesting. On my way, let's do this. Kat is bot. Fiora is there. We can insta-kill her. I mean, there's three people. Bard is coming. Yep, Bard is there. They should be able to take this, no problem. Ram is just going to zone everybody away. Kill everyone. So, ult. She's dead. Yep. Take the journey. Good. Did I just get... No. Got chained to the wall. Thought for a second I got chained by my shadow. I was like, wait, what? Alright. So, insta-clearing waves. This is part of what makes Zed such an amazing split pusher, is just how fast he destroys waves of minions. It's absolutely insane. Oh, by the way, we got Baron. So, life is good. Life is really good. I think we might just be able to end the game here. Because Bard cannot do anything. Yeah. Is he gonna be it? He's really tanky. He is the one person on their team that I can't easily kill. Alright, gonna do that. We're gonna be fine. Alright, you wanna try to fight us? Let's go. Alright. So, she ulted there in the middle of that. Kept her out of our damage. Gangplank had come to help there. Probably would have survived that. Or at least he could have finished off the enemy. But no worries. So, all they have now is their Nexus turret. Well, not even their Nexus turret, just their Nexus. Yeah. Life is going good for us. So, can't quite afford this. Instead, gonna upgrade my trinket. Because we do need some more wards. Because as you guys can see, we don't have any vision at all. This is pretty bad. Normally you want to be able to see what's going on. Helps you get picks. For example, if we kill this Graves now, that's a lot of damage gone. Well, you know. Yeah. AD carries at this point, if you can burst them, you can just find them walking through the jungle on their own. That's a huge buff to you guys. So, I'm going to try to see if I can't sneak through the jungle or even just split push top and get that inhib. Because then that'll be two down. The rest of my team is bot side. So, if I can pull two people top, then that's huge imbalance for us, where we have more people bot who can do things, they just don't, and we get stuff done. Alright, looks like some people are dying down there. Not a great start to it. But, Gangplank helping split push up here. We should easily be able to get this in here. Or Fiora can kill everyone. Not the result I was expecting, not gonna lie. Thought they should be able to deal about it. Should be able to deal with it. And now I got a feeling that they're coming for me.
Balance is a fool's master.
I want to try to get this inhib though. No, just kidding. Hit him with that, hit him with that. He's finally getting some armor. So, gonna go back. Can't quite afford the Black Cleaver. Alright, Gangplank on a rampage. Doing some work. I'm just gonna keep pushing up here. Fiora's bot. I'm not scared of the monkey. I can kill this so fast. Bard, would you stop that? Alright, there's an inhib for us. Cool. Use this, and we're fine. Nope. Alright. Have them take the dragon. Can finally pick up the Black Cleaver. Thought it would be fine from the Wukong ult there. Turns out he flashed for us, so it's whatever. They got a dragon, putting the score at 4-2. Not ideal. But Rammus. Rammus going big. I don't know if you can do this, friend. I don't know about this one. Wukong trying to BM him. Oh, so close. So close. Alright. One more auto and that would have died. That's... Oh. Oh, that's terrible. Alright, he's gonna die. Gangplank. I don't know why you're pushing. If you run in and hit the Nexus twice, we win the game. Oh, man. Alright. Let's see. What can we do? Well, gonna start out by clearing out bot. Gonna drop some wards. Gangplank gonna get a kill on the cat. Urgot gonna be starting to kill the Yuki. Wukong going in, taking out the Gangplank. Let's see, Urgot going big. Alright. Looks like Urgot's gonna make it out just fine. Or is he? He should be right. Ah, that looks fine. Bard is really fast though. Gotta be honest, this is like the first time I've seen a bard do something useful. I'm impressed. Apparently he actually does have potential. Cool. Alright, they're coming for me. I can feel it. Let's drop a ward here. Because if I can see him coming, I can start making my great escapes. Don't want to deal with the Fiora, but if I can keep her busy.
Balance is a fool.
Alright, here comes the Wukong. Don't want to deal 2v1. Katarina's here as well. Oh, Rammus? He's going for it. Rammus is going for it. Does he have it? Does he have it? No. Rammus does not have it. think he probably needs to stop doing that, because if we just win one team fight, this game is ours. However, if we keep letting them snowball, we let the Wukong actually get tanky, then we might have a problem.
Alright. Fear the shrouded path.
I'm gonna wait till I can see them. Because how's the Nexus? 700. 350 AD per attack.
Secrets kept, our weapons wasted.
Alright, Wukong is out. Graves left. Alright, I'm going for it. Nope, we're dead. This was a terrible idea. Yeah, that was really stupid. I knew I shouldn't have done that, but it was just so tempting. You guys know the feeling, right? Alright, we really, really just need to group. We can win this very easy, because as you guys can see, we can three-shot all of them. You know, even just the Udyr. Full damage. Apparently everyone is just going full damage this game. Cool. This is an interesting one, guys. This is definitely an interesting one. Oh, Udyr's dead. Paramus is going for it once again. You really need to stop, friend. You're not gonna get this. You're not gonna get this. Okay, you two can go up and right-click that twice. Hit it twice, and you win. Flash, auto. The game is won. Guys, this is ridiculous. We might just win because Baron minions. Alright, GG. So, there you guys have it. Beginner's Guide to Zed. You go in, you get your damage items, you shadow in, you ult someone, you blow them up, and then you shadow back out. It's that simple. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, like, subscribe, tell me what you thought in the comments below. I'll see y'all next time. Peace.